Welcome back to Wild Tribe. Whoever had a birthday this week, happy birthday. And to all the dads, I wish you a happy Father's Day. Please get your moms, dads, or guardians. We're going to do praise and worship.
Yay! Yeah!
Darkness closes in on every side. When battles rage and when the waters rise, I fear no evil, for I know the truth. Nothing can separate my heart from you, 'cause there's no weapon stronger than there's no weapon strong. faith can make the mountain move, and nothing is impossible.
Girl. Isn't praise and worship a wonderful gift from God to us, allowing us to express our love for Him to music and dance and movement? We're able to use the words of others who are even better than us at putting our love for God into words and then singing these words to Him. Wonderful gift. Thank you, Jesus, for that wonderful privilege. Guys, if you'd like to quickly now go and grab your Bibles, that'd be great. We're going to be looking at some of the letters of Paul, looking at some of the stuff that the Holy Spirit inspired Paul to write that tells us how to live now that we are Christians. So if you want to go grab your Bibles, that'll be great. And now we're going to watch a helpful video about how the Holy Spirit changes the way we think, so we can think the way God wants us to.
Paul was a missionary and teacher in the early church. He traveled all over sharing the good news about Jesus and teaching believers. When Paul couldn't meet with believers face to face, he wrote letters.
Paul wrote a letter to the believers in Rome about how they should live differently than people who do not trust in Jesus. Paul said that God calls believers to be friends with one another and to show love to everyone.
Paul reminded the believers that God is merciful. He shows us love even though we are sinners and do not deserve His love. Paul said, "So live in a way that pleases God. Do not let the unbelievers around you change how you think. Let God change how you think. The Holy Spirit lives inside you. He shows you the right way to live, and you will know God's good plan for you.
Do not think you are better or worse than you really are. Not every believer is the same. God gives faith to all believers, and not everyone has the same amount of faith. God gives each believer different gifts. Some people have the gift of prophecy or the gift of teaching. Some have the gift of serving or encouraging or giving or leading or showing mercy. Believers must work together, like different parts of a body working together. We are all one body in Jesus. Our job is to love one another like a family. We rejoice in hope, choose patience during hard times, and do not stop praying."
Paul wrote, "If someone is happy, we are happy with him. If he is sad, we are sad with him. Get along with one another as much as possible." Later, Paul was in a prison in Rome. He wrote a letter to Christians in Philippi. Paul was happy because God was working in their lives. The Christians helped Paul by sending him money and praying for him. Paul thanked God for the believers. He knew that God was changing them to be more like Jesus.
God wants us to show friendship and love to one another. As believers, we all belong to Jesus. His death and resurrection brings us together. The Holy Spirit changes the way we think and live, so we can love one another as God has loved us.
Awesome. Very helpful video. And if we read Paul's letters, we see that he always does it this way. He gives us what God has done in the first half of his letters. He explains how it is Jesus that has saved us, that it's nothing that we've done. It's that we can't read our Bibles enough. We can't go to church enough. We can't do enough good things to be saved. But God, in his mercy, saved us through what he did on the cross through Jesus Christ. So now the next thing is, how do we then live? How do we live in response to that? And the fact is, the way we think has to be changed. That is what renewing our minds means. And it is the Holy Spirit that renews our minds. But how does He do that? What is the way that the Holy Spirit changes the way we think? And I think to help us understand that process, we have these four pictures just to show us some of the stages as we think more and more like Jesus, the way that God wants us to. So over here, in the first picture, this is before we are saved. As you can see, these two people, they don't love Jesus. They are dirty with sin, like we are all dirty with our sin. And look, these are their thought bubbles. Do you see what they're thinking? They're not thinking the way God wants them to think. They're thinking the way the world wants them to think. They're thinking the way that everyone else who doesn't know Jesus thinks about any issue that you could maybe consider. They think that they must always be first. They think that the world is about becoming everything that they can become on their own and for what they want. However, that's not the way Jesus wants us to think. Jesus wants us to put others ahead of ourselves. And if you look over here, these guys have come to know Jesus. These guys have come to know Jesus. You can see their sins have been washed away. Their hearts have been made new. They now have a disposition. This is where we are. We now might have some feelings. We might have some influence of the Holy Spirit that we're starting to kind of want what God wants. But look here, as new Christians and even some older Christians are not always thinking the way God wants us to think. We're still thinking the way we used to think before we were saved. We still think it's okay to maybe back chat our moms. We still think that we should think about taking the biggest piece of cake and not really thinking about what other people should want. We're not thinking the way God wants us to think, even though He has truly saved us. And this is the question: how are our minds changed? What changes our mind? And the next picture helps us understand that. Here we see what changes us. It's the main way that the Holy Spirit changes us is that He talks to us through the Bible. You have to understand, the Holy Spirit wrote the Bible. Every single word in the Bible, Old and New Testament, is what the Holy Spirit wrote for us to read and understand. And when we read it, it's the Holy Spirit who changes the way we think. You can see here in these pictures, the word is going in to the minds of these two people. And slowly, you see over here, they still have a lot of wrong thinking, but look, they're starting to think the way Jesus wants them to think. They're starting to see the world the way God wants us to see the world. And while we're never going to be perfect on this earth before Jesus comes back, the idea is that as we grow in Jesus, as we read the Bible more and more, we should be thinking more and more the way God wants us to think. We're actually having Him change the way we think. Our minds are being transformed to think the way Jesus wants us to think, because the way we think determines how we behave. So guys, we shouldn't be thinking or learning to think by what movies we watch, by what non-Christians are telling us the whole time. They might have some good insights, but the way we can judge whether what they're saying is a good way to think about things is by knowing what the Bible says. And I'm actually going to quickly read here from Romans 12, verse 2, where it says, and this is one of the verses that they said in the video, "Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your minds." By reading the Bible and starting to think the way God thinks, we change the way that we think. "So by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect." How do we know what God's will is? How do we know what God wants? It's by reading the Bible that the Holy Spirit wrote, and then applying that to everything that we watch. I enjoy movies. My boys and I and my wife, we enjoy movies. But we have to understand that we judge what is good in a movie by what the Bible says. We don't let the movie tell us what's good and right when they are non-Christian movies. We know from what the Bible says that what is good and acceptable and perfect in God's eyes by reading the Bible. And I just want to add, and obviously by reading the Bible prayerfully. It's not just about knowing what the Bible says, but believing and understanding what the Bible says by the grace of the Holy Spirit. So we must read the Bible and pray and ask the Holy Spirit to help us understand it and help us then to do what the Bible is telling us. So even when I feel this one way, or the whole world, every movie, all the stuff, all the TV shows, all of my friends at school who don't love Jesus or maybe saying something, I still have to say, but no, I'm going to believe what the Bible says. I'm going to believe what God has told me in His Word. And in love, tell people that this is the right way to believe and the right things to do. And then we have to do it. The Bible says, love others the way you want, you know, love others the way Jesus loves you. Treat others the way you want them to treat you. Forgive your enemies, even when they haven't said sorry. These are not easy things. And I can promise you now, boys and girls, it's not that As adults, we have this all together. We're still being changed in our thinking by reading the Bible, and we still struggle. But we can't change and say, well, maybe they're right, when it's clearly not. When the Bible has said something clearly and we understand what the Bible says, that is the truth. And even if the whole world says something else, the Bible is where the Holy Spirit has most clearly told us what He wants from us and explained to us how God thinks. So we just pray, Holy Spirit, I just pray right now, Lord God, help us to read our Bibles with understanding, and then help us to live out our Bibles in our schools and work and universities and at our friends' houses and even with our families who might not be, family members who might not be Christian. Help us, Holy Spirit, to believe the truth and think the way You think wherever we go. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hi kids, today's memory verse is 2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away, behold, the new has come. Thank you.
Okay guys, and as always, the Bible summary in 10 words. No stock footage here. Let's do it together, guys. And God rules. We sinned. God provided. Jesus gives, and we respond. If anyone asks you, what do you believe? You can say those 10 words. We believe that God rules, that we sinned, but it was God that provided in Jesus. Jesus gave His life for us, and we then respond to His sacrifice.